No, this is not a dream. You can now automate your investments on interactive brokers because they recently just released a new feature called recurring investments that allows you to invest a fixed amount of money on a stock or ETF based on your preferred schedule and interval, and even auto-convert your currencies. And what that means is you can set a start and end date and choose whether you want to invest the money daily, weekly, monthly, or even yearly. Then sit back and relax already. Very useful, right? So without further ado, let's get started. Now log into your interactive broker's web portal on your computer and click on the trade button. You will then see recurring investments, so go ahead and click into that. Next, click on create recurring investment and you will see this box popping up asking you for some details. You can search for the stock either through the ticker symbol, company name, ISIN or QSIT, which is a serial number to identify the particular stock or ETF, and you can easily find them through a simple Google search or find them through their respective fun fact sheet. And for US stocks like say Apple, Microsoft, Tesla, etc., I think it's pretty straightforward to get them, and the same goes for US ETFs, for example the S&P 500 ETFs. You can just search for their name or ticker symbol. While as for island domicile ETFs such as those listed on the London Stock Exchange in United Kingdom, they can help you to save some money from the US dividend with holding tax, but I need to let you know that you cannot trade fractional shares over there because it is only applicable to US stocks and ETFs only. But if you have no idea what I'm talking about here, then you should probably check out this video that I'll put on the top right hand corner for you. It's also worth noting that for island domicile S&P 500 ETFs or just any European ETFs, it's a bit tricky to get the exact ETF, so you need to type in either the ISIN or QSIP, which you can find in the fun fact sheet like I've mentioned earlier. So let's say I want to set up an auto investment for Tesla stock, then it should return with a list of exchanges that offer Tesla. Now select Tesla Inc. listed on the Nasdaq Stock Exchange and traded in US dollar, and then fill in your preferred start to end date, amount and interval, and in this case since I want to let it automate for an entire year, so I will set from today 27 February 2023 to 27 February 2024, an amount of 100 US dollars and an interval of monthly, but feel free to set either daily, weekly or quarterly, the choice is all yours. So double check the details and click on continue, and final step, review your details and click on save investment, and once clicked you should see the confirmation message on your screen. Your trade will then be executed once the US stock market opens and you are done. Easy peasy, right? And in case you want to change any settings, just head back to the main page and click on the pencil button to edit. Okay, if you want to use this feature, there are a few things you need to take note of. Firstly, the recurring investment feature is not yet available on the Trader Workstation TWS software as well as the IBKR mobile app. At least that's what I know for now. Not the worst thing because you can obviously just use it on their web portal. And number two, all trades for this feature will always follow the standard fixed structure listed on the IBKR website, which comes at a minimum commission charge of $1 per trade instead of the 35 cents over on the tiered structure which we all know and love. Yes, this sucks. For some reason, they decided to do that, so do consider this one. And thirdly, if your account doesn't have enough money for the trade, the recurring investment will not happen, even if you have the feature turned on. Makes sense, right? And number four, you can only buy the stock or ETF based on the dollar amount, i.e. US dollar, and not as one whole share, which most likely will end up being a fractional share for US stocks and ETFs. So depending on the amount you put, you might end up with a fraction of a share, a whole share, or even more than one share. But for say stocks or ETFs in the UK, if you don't have enough cash for at least one whole share, then it will not execute the trade for you. And lastly, as I've mentioned earlier, if you don't have sufficient cash balance for the particular currency, say US dollar or Great Britain pound, then IBKR will perform auto currency conversions for you when the trade executes. So that will cost you $2 each time. So it's best if you convert the currencies in a lump sum to avoid that from happening. So yeah, I just wanted to share with you about this new cool feature which I think is super useful for those of you who have been wanting to automate this whole manual investing process, because I know for a fact that many of you actually don't like to log in onto your brokerage platform that often. Hey, nothing wrong, right? There's more to life than just looking at share price or staring at your portfolio. So now that you have learned how to automate your investment on interactive brokers, I would highly recommend you to now check out this video to learn more about the top S&P 500 ETFs that you can set your investments to automate and start letting your money work for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you over there.